Hey guys, Stealth Jacob here, and welcome back to the Direwolf 21.10 mod pack. Today, we're going to do a couple of things. The first thing I'm going to do is actually explore the world a bit, and possibly find a nicer place to live. That's option number one. And the second thing we're going to do is try and collect some sand and some other resources so we can build ourselves a smeltery. There's mobs here. Okay. That's cool. The mobs aren't dying yet. That's not a problem. There's not too many left. So we can just kill them. If I can hit them. Alright. Ooh, we got a zombie head from that. That's cool. I think you can use that for stuff. And I also put a waypoint down so we can find our base. Ow. Skeletons are the worst. Okay. We're good with that. Let's harvest our wheat. You can actually harvest it just by right-clicking. And you do get seeds from this, so it's a really good option to do. Alright. So let's move around and try and find some suitable locations. Also, we'll grab some sand on the way, just because we're going to build a smeltery soon, and we need sand for it. We have all the other materials, but sand is what we're missing. So, yeah, we'll grab some sand right now. Just because we can. Alright, that's a good amount for a start. We'll come back and get more later if we need to. But we got this big ravine here, which I actually never went in yet. But that's still cool. We can go in there eventually if we want to. So, yeah, it's right next to our little base here, so that's fine. Not a problem. Okay, let's move this way. We're heading south on our map. We got a... Ooh, there's some sheep up there. That's really nice. And we're also going to lag a little bit, just because we are loading new chunks in. Got a small cave a little there here. Oh, wow. We got a lot of cool stuff up here. There's some mountains. It's relatively flat, which... I mean, I'm a fan of flat areas. There's some pigs here. There are sheep, though. We might want to go get those sheep and get a bed. That would be really good, actually. Let's go do that. They're on a really tall mushroom, though. It's going to be hard to get them. How'd you get up there? You crazy sheep? Parkour, huh? But yeah, we'll kill these sheep. We'll get some wool. We can build a bed. That'll be really good. Then we don't need to wait till nighttime. Or wait till daytime all the time. Oh gosh, can we make this jump? Yeah, because we're not bad at parkour. Okay, we got one wool. We're just going to get the three wool we need. Alright, what did he drop? What is this used for? A solidified experience. That's really interesting. I've never seen that before. But we have enough wool to make a bed now, which is really good. Now we don't need to wait till daytime all the time. We can just sleep. But yeah, let's keep scouting in this direction. It looks like there's more sand that way too, so we can build more smeltery stuff. This area right here that we are, it looks really flat. It has a nice view too. Look at that, like mountains and stuff. This could be a decent spot. We could like clear out this hill right here with the chickens on it. That would be a bad spot. Grab some more wood, I guess. Yeah, that would not be bad. I can see the spot being good. We'll keep scouting around though. Maybe we'll find something even better. Some eggs. Take that. Eggs are useful. Make a chicken farm. But yeah, wasn't there sand in this direction? No, I know. It might have been the other one. But that's okay. There's more areas to explore. Alright. There's some caves and stuff. It's pretty cool. Let's get on these hills and see what's over them. What do we got? Oh my gosh, a lot of chickens. We're gonna kill some of you guys for now. Get some more food. That's awesome. Look at all the chickens here. There's so many. That's insane. Okay. Looks like this is where the ocean is nearby. So that's pretty good. If we wanted to make a base right around here, that wouldn't be awful. Yeah, we could like flatten out these big hills here. Possibly. It's always a possibility. Alright. There's a slime island up there. That's really cool. Slime islands are pretty neat. They're really interesting. Alright. Yeah, I like these areas already. Wild coffee. Coffee. Cool, we got coffee, I guess. Not sure how that works. Oh wait, let's go get some sand from the beach. Get some sand for the builds, you know? Then we can build the stuff. Oh wow, there's a lot of sand. Oh, what time of day is it? It's okay, it's noon. Just making sure we have a lot of time to get back so we don't get attacked by mobs. It looks like we are finding some decent spots though, which I am happy about. Alright. Yeah, let's just get a bunch of sand. We're definitely gonna have enough to build a smeltery right now, so that's good. I am liking one spot right now at the moment. I like, where is it? I really like this. Oh, that's, I like this area. It has this big water area to they can like fish in and stuff. Yeah, I like this area the best so far, but yeah, I'm gonna think about it more, and I'll also explore a bit more. Maybe we'll find something really cool. We can also build multiple bases if we want, but yeah, I would like maybe one big base, I guess. I don't know. We'll see. We will see in the future. Yeah, let's mine a bit of this. That's probably good. Broke our shovel. We have a spare, right? Yep. Let's just mine a bit of this so it's a bit closer to the land. Yeah, we got over 2 stacks of sand so far. That's pretty good. Alright. Yeah, I'm just gonna mine this and that'll be it for that. Cool. We got a ton of sand. Now we can build a smeltery when we want to. Let's explore. It's like noon, okay? So we have a little bit of time. Let's head more in this direction. I guess let's head like towards our house, but like this way more, I guess. Just see what we can find. Don't forget to eat. It's a good thing. Got some big hills, another slime island. Pretty neat. More chickens, which are nice. Alright. So this is another beach area. That's cool. Let's head up this giant hill in this direction. Looks like we got a big forest here too. We can get a ton of wood from that if we need so. A lot of birch trees too. Is this a birch forest biome? Yep, it is. It's a birch forest. Okay, cool. Yeah, let's just head like this way a little bit, see what we can find. Maybe, is that like the end of the island? Who knows? Is this an island or a continent? I don't even know. Okay. We can see on the map there's coastline in this direction. That's pretty cool. I think I see lava. Is that right? That's a bit weird if we do. Lava's next to the ocean. That's kind of weird. Alright. Oh, there's lava. That's cool. Let's head up this way. Okay, let's start heading towards our house. It's getting darker. Let's head in the direction. But yeah, I am really liking the first area that we found over there. Just because it's somewhat flat already, and it wouldn't be too difficult to flatten more of it. Alright. Yeah, like over next to this watery area. I mean, because I could build Even with the hills, I could build like stairs or something, and that would be fine. That would make it look pretty nice. And it's just a wide area. And there's this extra area on the other side of the water we can survive on. We could build like a cool building in the mountain there. I'm thinking this might be a decent spot. All right. So this is my number one spot so far. If you guys have any ideas from what we saw so far, leave a comment down below. If you, I don't know, maybe you agree with that spot or something. But yeah, I want to hear you guys think about it. If you think that's a good spot or not. We haven't seen a lot of areas, but I don't know, that's a good starting. That might be a really good spot just because it's flat. And there's a lot of potential there. Alright, let's head home and make some smeltery stuff. Let's get some ore doubling happening. Alright, so what I'm gonna do for this is actually cut a bit of a hole in my wall. Actually, we can do that on the inside. Okay, so let's make. So we need to make grout. Group, grout. Grout is made with gravel, clay, and sand. Let's. Oh, we need more chests, huh? Let's turn this into a double chest. There we go. Okay, let's put this stuff away. Let's put it right here. Alright, let's just throw a bunch of crap in it. Oh, actually, we can make a bed. Let's do that. I forgot about that. That's a big thing. Now we can sleep during the day. I mean, night. I don't know what I'm talking about. Oh, cool. It's a white bed. I didn't know it did that. Where are we gonna put it? That's a good spot. That's okay. All right. So we're gonna make some grout now. We need gravel, clay, and sand. Let's grab the clay, gravel. We have the least amount of gravel by the look of it. So we might have to go down in the cave and get more. We have two stacks of it of this though. So let's grab 16 coal and smelt that up. Right now. We'll do eight there and smelt you and eight there and smelt you. And while that's hap okay, it's actually night. Let's sleep in our new bed that we just made. Oh man, that's awesome. I'm glad we got a bed now. Now we can sleep through the night. I have some chicken. Let's get some more food. Actually, do I have a hoe on me anywhere? There we go, wooden hoe. Let's get some more farmland going. We can actually cut this tree down too. It's not really useful here. Yeah, we'll do that. All right, there it goes. Now we got more farmland. Oh, we broke it. All right, we're getting a good amount of wheat though, which is nice. Get a lot of bread. Bread's pretty good. It's one of the better foods in Minecraft. Oh, I got. What do worms do? You can recycle them, I guess. That's a bit weird. I don't know. Not too many uses for them. Let's plant around the sugarcane farm, though. Alright. That should be plenty of land, because for expansion. Let's place a couple torches around it, too, just to make sure it's lit. Yeah, that should be good. So now when we get more wheat, we can just keep planting it. And yeah, we'll also break some of these. Give us wheat. We need more wheat. What kind of seeds are these again? These are hemp seeds. What is hemp used for? You can make biomass. And I think you can make like a plant oil. Okay, that's cool. I don't know what plant oil is used for. That's fine. We're just gonna keep breaking some grass right now. Getting some more seeds. That's good. Oh, the bees are stinging me. I really like how the bees that are really like they attack you sometimes if you're too close. That's really cool. It's a really smart mechanic. I do believe that bees also will hurt you a lot when you destroy the hive. They do a couple hearts of damage, which does make sense, you know. It's sort of, bees will sting you if you attack them. It's part of, that's what they do. Alright, let's make some wheat, or bread. Alright, so we are getting our seared bricks, which is what we need. So what we need is, we need to make a lot of seared bricks like this. We also need to make a seared tank, which is bricks around one piece of glass. We can get... Okay, that's the seared tank still. What else is there? The furnace... Oh. Wait, what? Oh, okay, they changed the recipe. So, you need to have a furnace inside of that now, which I did not know. Let's build that. Okay, furnace, and then seared bricks around it. Smeltery controller. I'm gonna have this thing sort of on the outside of my house for now. So I'm gonna break down this wall. I guess. What is this? What else do we need? We have the furnace controller. We don't need windows really. A sear tank is what we need, but we're cooking not that glass right now. Let's make some seared bricks actually. Okay. Alright, how many bricks do we get? We get about 10. That's a, yeah. It takes a lot of seared brick to get a lot of seared bricks. So we're just gonna build a little 3x3 smeltery, I guess. Like this. And then you have to build a wall around it. Like that. What else do we need? We need... So, smeltery stuff. We have the controller. We need a drain. Okay, yeah. We need one of those. That will be good. So, smeltery drain... We'll place the drain right here for now. What else? We need a lot of different parts to build this thing. And actually, where's my book? I should read the book. This book sort of tells you how to get started with it. Oh, it looks a lot nicer. So it tells you how to build like the smeltery. It looks like that. It's pretty cool. Yeah, it just gives you a lot of nice information. So that's pretty handy. You can learn about the different materials you can make. Like, how do you make a firewood stuff? Well, it doesn't say how to make it, but it says a lot of cool things. There's also multiple things you can add to your weapons and tools. It's just a really cool mod. What else? We need a faucet, which is three of those. We need a faucet. There we go. We need, what are we building? We'll build a, we won't build a basin. A basin is basically, you can make blocks of the material in here, but we're just going to do something different because we need to have another thing. So let's make a casting table instead. A casting table can help you build all the different tool types, which is really handy. Okay. I don't know if we'll have enough seared brick. It's going to be kind of close. Okay, let's put some more around it. Place a piece of gravel. Alright. We're getting it done. It's going to be done pretty soon, actually. What else can we build from the mod that we can use right now? So we're gonna build the tank right there. Which we need the, wait, do we have glass? No, we don't. Okay. We have sand though, we can make some. I'm also just gonna make more, as much of this as I can. We have some extra sand, so we're good and stuff. We're out of gravel, that's what we need. All right, we're just gonna put half of that in there. We'll actually put all of it in here, and we'll have it cook. All right, it's not turning too dark yet. So what else do we need? We can make all the different tools from the mod, or the benches and stuff, I think. Are they in here? We need, yeah, there's like part builders and all this stuff. How do you build those? So there's a lot of mods with, or a lot of cool things you can do. So Tinker's Construct is the name of the mod. Okay, so we need to make all of these different tools. So the stencil table is made of wood. Okay, we just need to get a lot of wooden stuff. Throw this stuff away. All right, we're getting some more. Oh, we need more fuel for that. I forgot. Let's just put 10 in. That'll be good. All right, cool. So what we need first is we need to make blank patterns, which are made out of sticks and wooden planks. So you make wooden patterns or patterns like this, and you get four of them. So that's a pretty good number. Now, you can get a bunch of these pat you can make these things into a lot of stuff. For instance, that's a part builder. Let's do that. What else? You can make this a stencil table. There's a crafting station, a pattern chest. Okay, we'll build that. Let's build a pattern chest so we can hold our patterns when we build them. We built that one. Tool station. We need to make a crafting table. We can do that. Let's make a crafting table and then put the stencil on top of it. It's tool station. And something else I'm gonna do is I'm gonna break my crafting table now and turn it into the other crafting table, which looks like this. What's cool about this one is it actually holds the items. Oh, look, you can actually access stuff from the furnace in it too. It's very handy. It's turning dark again. Okay. We're gonna finish off the episode by making the smeltery, and then next episode we're gonna start building some tools with it. All right. So we're just gonna need to finish this thing. And yeah. And I'll actually put some metal in it and we can see it work. Let's just dump that water out because we won't need it. All right, it's nighttime again. That's cool. No problem. Okay, cool. Now it's daytime. This bed was a great idea. All right, that's done. Let's cook up some sand so we can get that. And we'll build the tank right away. And then we can just use the rest of our seared bricks to build the wall of it. How is this built like this? Seared tank. Okay. So you put the tank here. And what you do with the tank is you fill the tank with lava, and that will fuel the smeltery. And how many more bricks do we need? We need one. We need four, huh? Three, four. All right, four bricks. That should be a working smeltery now. Right? Why not? Have we done something wrong? I don't know. We're gonna break this wall though, I guess, because we can. How do you assemble a smeltery again? Smeltery. The smeltery can be 3x3. It can be All right. Not sure why it's not really working yet. What a how Because all you need to get it to start up is to have all the sides sort of filled in. Oh, maybe we need to put lava in it. Maybe that'll help. So let's go get some lava from the cave down below. And we can start smelting stuff and getting twice the amount of ore that we would get, which is very efficient. Especially early on in the game like this, getting double the ore for each piece is really good. Especially for like iron. Alright. Let's grab a bucket of lava and let's head back up to the surface. Alright. I'm not sh Hopefully this makes it work. I'm really It has updated and I don't so I'm not really sure if it will or not. It's a bit weird. You build a Like, let's just look at the parts here. Where's the smeltery parts? Oh, we built the wrong thing. Okay. I get it, guys. We built the wrong thing. Okay. That's my bad. I don't know why that was. Why did we build this? Does it do anything? Alright, so we need to remove this because I built the wrong thing. Hopefully we can find a use for it though, because we did spend a bit of stuff on it. So never mind, it is like the old school way where you have a smeltery controller. I placed the wrong one. A smeltery controller. There we go. Okay. I'm gonna learn figure out what that does though. Okay. So we have lava in here now. Now if we get out some iron, we have 10 iron. Let's grab that. And if we place it in here, we can do up to 9 items currently, because that's how big it is. And you can increase the size of it by making it taller and wider and stuff. Yeah, so we have some stuff smelting. We have 9 iron in here. Let's just see how much iron we get when it's done. And I need to figure out what this does, because I wasted stuff on it. What does it do? We'll figure it out later. I'll look it up. But yeah, let's see. It should double our iron to get like 18. I'm pretty sure. Let's see. It's gonna be pretty cool. In next episode, we'll start using this stuff to build some tools and things. It'll be really fun. So let's just see. And yeah, the fuel's going down because it's using it. We put 9 iron in. How much iron do we get out? We get 2 blocks worth, which is 18 iron. So we have a working smeltery and it's awesome. But anyways, guys, I want to thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode of the Direwolf 20 1.10 mod pack. And yeah, I will see you guys next time. See ya!